back to that Dallas hospital and whether it blew it by not following federal guidelines and initially at least misdiagnosing the Ebola case. Dr. Frank Glover says we lost valuable time, and that is putting a lot of people at risk. He is a doctor of public health. And, doctor, I guess the argument was when Mr. Duncan was first not admitted into the hospital, in fact, he was released on the first signs of what appeared like Ebola-like symptoms. They dismissed it, even when he said he had been in Liberia. What should they have done?
Well, it's unfortunate that the patient was discharged home, but not having all the facts, it's sometimes difficult to second guess. We do know that the patient was not forthright in disclosing his contact with another Ebola patient that had died. He had had contact with a patient that died, and 3 days later he aborted a plane and came here. And it's troubling that he didn't share that information with the people at the hospital, namely that he had been exposed to someone with Ebola. And so when we make diagnoses, 90% of it is based on history, but the history has to come from the patient. And if the patient is willingly suppressing the truth of the matter, then it makes the job more difficult.
Well, maybe he felt, maybe he felt that since he wasn't exhibiting any signs, despite all we know now about it, there's a 21-day incubation, he thought he was in the clear. I guess what happened at this hospital is he did mention that he had been to Liberia, at least had revealed that much, didn't say anything about having been with a dying Ebola patient, but he was exhibiting stomach cramps, that kind of thing, that are normally not associated with Ebola, and I guess that was among the reasons why the hospital let him go. Have we widened our definition of what should keep someone in a hospital if they're exhibiting any of these signs?
Well, we have to have a high index of suspicion. The CDC has guidelines in place. Unfortunately, in this case, one of the sentinel events was missed, namely travel from Liberia. It's unfortunate that that happened at the hospital, but it has happened. So what can we do going forward? We have to go out and, as the CDC is doing, chase down every known contact and quarantine those individuals to see if they develop symptoms. But now, when these patients, if one should develop symptoms, presents to the hospital, it would be important for that person who may not have traveled to Liberia to say that they had contact with someone who had Ebola. And that would, in fact, give the professionals an alert. It's kind of like in this country, if someone's having a heart attack or a stroke, we call ahead, someone's having chest pain. That person doesn't come to the hospital and sit in the waiting room. They go straight back for immediate treatment and intervention. We don't need people with Ebola going to the emergency room and sitting in the emergency room amongst other patients and exposing people unnecessarily. Okay. They need to call, as the CDC has suggested, that we have the suspected Ebola situation, and that person would then be taken directly to an isolation ward, and all of the personnel dealing with that patient would have on full protective equipment so as to minimize the risk of infection of the health professionals.
All right. Doctor, thank you. Good words of advice. We appreciate it.